Everybody should have those charts out. Hey, head up, take it on the turn, hit you.
Oh, that is going in, man. Don't tell me.
Okay, all right, so we've already moved them left, right, up, down, okay? And we've reflected them over the X and Y axis. Now we're gonna make them fat or skinny. So, let's talk about what we're gonna put in these boxes. If I do anything that's horizontal, we have to step inside, okay? And it's always gonna be over one. It's always gonna be the reciprocal. So what we're gonna write is we're gonna have f of x turns into f of one over v of x. Let's talk about what that b represents. Anybody got an idea of what B represents?
Why?
That's a good guess.
The number that you got to move.
Yes, sort of, yes. What we're going to call that is the horizontal stretch compress factor. Okay? It's going to be whatever they tell us is going to always go over one. And we're going to do some examples here in a minute when you guys get done writing that so that we can see that there's a pattern that happens every time. Is this addition, subtraction, or multiplication going on here?
Multiply.
So this is going to be multiply. Okay? Am I multiplying everything or am I just multiplying x? What do you guys think? What's that notation say? Am I multiplying everything or just multiplying x? Does that even see me in the picture?
Probably multiplying not. Everything in the parentheses.
Okay, well, what's in the parentheses? What's in the parentheses?
X.
So am I multiplying everything or am I just multiplying x? X. So we're only multiplying x. Okay? So, I'm going to go up here. So, how many of you guys remember your rules of multiplying and dividing fractions? This is our formula, 1 over b. So, what if I tell you that the factor, we want to do a horizontal compress, and make it skinny, of 1/2. What if I want to do a horizontal compress of 1/2? Where does that 1/2 go? What do we say?
Is it the B?
Yeah, it's the B, exactly. So this becomes 1/1/2. What's the rules for dividing fractions?
Dividing?
Uh-huh. Dividing?
Flip
them and multiply. So this says 1 divided by 1/2, and he's right. Keep, change, flip. Remember doing that? So this becomes 1 times 2 over 1, which is just
2.
So what happened here? It's the reciprocal. Okay? So watch. If we do this same thing, what if I tell you it is? What if I tell you it's 2/3? What do I put in place of B?
2/3.
Okay, so 1/2 is the same thing as 1/2. And what's the rule for dividing fractions? I
keep,
change, flip. So what happens? It becomes, what's 1 times 3/2?
3/2.
3/2. So what happened between here and here?
It
flips. Okay, so anytime I do anything that is a horizontal stretch or compress. When I put it over one, it just makes it the reciprocal, right? Mm-hmm. So if my factor was two, what's the reciprocal of two?
Mm-hmm.
1/2, okay? So be thinking about that, okay? That's just a fancy way of saying I wanna do the reciprocal. So if you wanna add that in here, maybe somewhere in here, parentheses, right? Reciprocal. Anytime you put anything over one and you go through all of the rules of dividing and multiplying fractions, you're gonna see all it's gonna do is flip everything. That's all it's gonna do, okay? Let's look at the next one. Anything that happens vertically, okay, takes the original function, and we're gonna multiply that entire function, right? So it's a times f of x. F of x represents that entire function. Does everybody agree?
Mm-hmm.
Is this multiplication, addition, subtraction? What do we got going on there?
Multiplication.
Okay. Multiply. Okay, do I multiply just the x or everything?
Everything.
Because this says I'm going to take this entire function and multiply. So we're going to multiply everything. Okay, let's look at this one. What does A represent in this one? B represented the horizontal stretch or compress. What's A gonna represent?
The vertical.
Good. A is gonna be my vertical. Like a big mystery. Stretch or compress factor. So let's do a couple of examples. We're gonna write the rule. So everybody has out their notes, right?
Mm-hmm.
It goes with this.
No, I don't know.
All right, so let's look at this one. It says, let g of x be a horizontal compression of f of x, 2x minus 1 by a factor of 1/3, okay? What is the original equation we're gonna work with here?
The f of x.
The f of x, okay, so here's where we start. Okay, what are they wanting me to do with this? What are they asking me to do?
Horizontally compress.
Okay, horizontally compress it. By what?
1/3.
By 1/3. So I have a horizontal compress of 1/3. So think about that. Horizontally compress, is it gonna get fat or skinny? Skinny, should get skinny. All right, now, looking at our box over here, what is the rule for a horizontal compress? The reciprocal. Does it go on the outside or on the inside? On the inside. So the rule becomes, every time, if I put anything in here, I'm only changing the x's. If I put something on the outside, it's changing the whole thing. Okay, this is 1/1/3. That's the rule. Do we all agree? And like she just said, whenever I go about doing this, it's gonna change that to the reciprocal. Every time, good, it's gonna be a 3. Every time I see an x, this replaces the x. So over here, I have to replace my x with 3x. Like he said, when we go through all of this, okay, we're gonna get reciprocal. Are we good? Okay. What do I do from here? I rewrite it. What do I rename it? What'd they tell me to rename it?
G of x.
G of x. So this becomes g of x. And then what?
Graph it.
I can graph it from here?
No, you gotta
make it easier.
So I have 6x, then what?
Minus 1.
Is it in its simplest form? Do I have any like terms that I haven't joined together?
Mm-hmm.
No, so we're good, right? Okay, where do I start graphing this one at?
Negative one.
And what is my slope on this one?
Up 6 over 1.
Okay, I missed my dot in the middle, but that's okay. So we said it was going to get skinny. Did it get skinny?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Sure.
Okay, all right, so far so good?
Mm-hmm.
Any questions so far? Some of you guys look like you're about to gouge your eyes out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's keep going. So let's try a vertical compress. Let's look at the difference. What's my starting equation? What's my original?
F of x equals 3x plus
7. Okay, good. Okay, where's your guys' notes? You need to have these out so you write this stuff down. These examples. Get your notes out.
I don't have any notes.
What are they asking me to do to this one? Yep. Vertical compress of a factor of what?
1/4.
1/4. Okay. So if I vertically compress something, is it going to get fat or skinny?
Fat.
Fat. Should get fat. Okay. Now, according to our rule, if I vertically compress something, where does that go?
Multiply.
I'm going to multiply the entire equation by what?
1/4
goes out here. I'm going to do that entire equation. This represents this. Does everybody understand that? If these two are equal, every time I see this, I can exchange it with this. Right? Okay? So 1/4. Okay, so what do I rename it? Okay?
G of X.
And then what?
One.
Now what?
Multiply.
Hey, okay, what do I get? 3/4. That's it? X. Does everybody see how I got 1/2? Okay. How do we multiply fractions? Do we keep change flip fractions? No, how do we multiply them? Straight across. So here, 3 times 1 is 3, 4 times 1 is 4. Over here, we would have 2 times 1, which would have given me 2, so I'm gonna go ahead and do this the long way. 4 times 1 is 4. Do these reduce? Can I take a 2 out of everything?
Yes.
That's how he jumped to the 1/2, okay? So g of x equals 3/4 x plus 1/2. If I was going to graph this thing, where would I start graphing it?
Up
1/2. What would my slope be?
3/4.
So up 3/4.
Up 3/4.
Mm-hmm.
Up 3 and then over 4. Okay, any questions on these so far? So far, so good? Yes, no, maybe? Is there another example? Okay. Go ahead and stop that for me, please.